to thee. I come before thee today to bring another video, not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah, amen. Woo! And I ask that she bless my crystalline eye, heart, and throat chakra, amen, but all my chakras, that I may speak not of my own mind, but of the eternal Shekinah, amen. I like to say one of my beloved precepts, which is Psalms 51:11. And it goes a little bit like this. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me thy joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with all thy free spirit. Look at the blue. Only through the Shekinah that is from the Father shall we get overstanding. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, we gonna say some of our ministries that we provide for the chosen children. You know what I'm saying? You want to contact us, go to Upper Eons on Facebook. You know what I'm saying? At the bottom of the video in the description box, I got my brother Rodolph's email, which is dothaman@al.com. It's my brother's Rodolph email, dothaman@al.com. And then you got my email, dearbeisrael@gmail.com. And we got a book buying ministry. You need a Nag Hammadi? Contact us. You know what I'm saying? And then we got the food ministry, named after my brother's Rodolph beloved mother, Chandra Johnson. You know what I'm saying? That is the name of our food ministry. You know any women or children that meet us, they may need assistance, contact us. All the information is in the description box at the bottom of the video. Then we got a video ministry by my brother Benaya, and also my brother Chase. That's on YouTube. That's also in the description box at the bottom of the video. You know what I'm saying? Check that out. You know what I'm saying? And then we got a blog talk, Lord's Will, every Sunday at 11 a.m. You know what I'm saying? Every Sunday at 11 a.m. You know what I'm saying? And we also got a POW talk, which is every Sunday at 12 p.m. You know what I'm saying? And the POW talk is called Sons of the L, numeral 2, all capital letters. Sons of the L, numeral 2, all capital letters. You know what I'm saying? This Sunday, the blog talk, we're not going to have it this Sunday because I have the boys. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to let my brother Rodolph know that. But with that being said, you know what I'm saying? With that being said, we're going to move on to the video. You know what I'm saying? Now, let's read the title of the video. You know what I'm saying? It says, Return of the Anunnaki Dove. It says, Return of the Anunnaki Dove. You know what I'm saying? So, the Anunnaki Dove is the Divine Mother. Our lineage is of the Anunnaki, Enki. You know what I'm saying? Which is the Most High. You know what I'm saying? Get overstanding. You've been watching the videos that the Divine Mother been having me put out. You know who Enki is. You know what I'm saying? So let's move on to the video that we may have overstanding what is about to take place up in this piece. Let's move on into the video. All right. Now, what we're going to do today is, look at the glory. What we're going to do today is, amen, I truly thank the Divine Mother, oh man, for the gift that she gives me to do her work and her will, pleasing unto her. You know what I'm saying? Amen. Before I do the video today, I want to give out a warning. Let me say that again. Before the Divine Mother bless me to do this video today, I want to give out a divine warning. Anybody who is weak in spirit, amen, let them not watch this video. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to read something from the Hopi prophecy. You know what I'm saying? That says the same thing. Look at the glory. Let the mother speak, that we may have understanding of the things that are about to take place up on this earth. Now, I'm going to read from the Hopi prophecy. Turn the music down, that I may give warning to people with weak spirits who have not prepared their souls and spirits for the things that are about to take place upon this earth. Let's read. I'm reading from the Hopi prophecy. It ain't on the screen. I'm reading it, but I done read this before in my last couple videos. Let's read. It said, those who return to the ways of old, meaning those who have prepared themselves spiritually in their spirit and soul. Those who return to the ways of old given to us in the original teachings of the Anunnaki, because they are the fathers and mothers of all civilization in the physical realm. You know what I'm saying? It's just that the Gentiles have distorted the information of the Anunnaki. The Anunnaki just means those who came from above, the agreeable and the disagreeable. This day you shall get right truth and right knowledge. Let's read. It say, those who return to the ways of old given to us in the original teachings and live a natural way of life will not be touched by the coming of the purifier. See the glory? The purifier is in the burial. You know what I'm saying? Like the Bible said, the destroyer of the Gentiles. The destroyer is Nibiru, plain and simple. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say it's on its way, which is Nibiru, Planet X, the nemesis system. You know what I'm saying? It say, and live a natural way of life will not be touched by the coming of the purifier. Or Nibiru. They will survive and build the new world. See that? That's talking about a chosen seed right there. Only in the ancient teachings of the Anunnaki, which is Enki, which is the Most High, who wrote the Bible, Enki and Enlil. You know what I'm saying? Will the ability to understand the messages be found? It is important to understand that these messages will be found upon every living thing, even within our bodies, and even within a drop of our blood. It's talking about the chosen seed. For only in our DEA shall this message be woke up. I am everything that is natural, and everything that is natural is me. Only the ones who do the ways of old, the ways of nature, who has the DEA of Enki, who is the creator of all things, who is the Most High, shall you get these messages. Let's read. It is important to understand that these messages will be found upon everything, every living thing. Talking about the code, the DNA blueprint of the divine creator. even within our body, see, the DNA or the DEA, even within a drop of our blood, the spirit and the DEA, all life forms will receive, bear with me, let me get the other part, will receive, all life forms will receive the message from the twins. I told you who the twin was, the red and blue Kachina that the Hopi talk about. The blue is Star Sirius, and the red is Nibiru. Now look at this coincidence. Remember on the Matrix, when it said to Neo, if you take the red pill, then you can go back to sleep and go into the world and we won't bother you no more. But if you take the blue pill, ye shall be awakened. You know what I'm saying? To the real reality and not illusion. And you cannot go back. The blue pill represents Star Sirius. The red pill represents Nibiru, destruction. You know what I'm saying? Because the ones who are asleep in illusion are and will be destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Unless they come over to the blue side. See that? The blue Kachina is Star Sirius. The red Kachina is the purifier, Nibiru. So if you want the dang red pill, take the red pill and go back into the world and go to sleep. But if you want the blue pill, like they said on the Matrix, then wake up. Arise, divine children. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. It say, the message from the twins, those that fly, the plants, to my the birds, the plants, even the rabbit. It say, the appearance of the twins began a period of 7 years will be our final opportunity. We are in the last 7 years right now. You know what I'm saying? To change our ways. Everything we experience is all a matter of choice. See that? You can choose to take the red pill or you can choose to take the blue pill. That is your choice. The red pill means you don't want to hear it. You don't believe it and you ain't trying to follow it. The blue pill is the awakener. You know what I'm saying? Now this part is what I'm reading for all the souls and spirits who are weak. Let's read. It say, many will appear to have lost their souls in these final days. See that? So intense. Let me say that again. So intense. Let me say that again. So intense will the nature of the changes be. See that? What he's saying is going to be devastating. That's why when people say, yeah, I know you telling me a deer what's going to happen, but why you telling me? Ain't nothing we can do about it. It's telling you. It's a whole lot you need to do about it. You need to seek the father and the mother. Seek your spiritual path and prepare yourself for what is coming. It says, so intense will the nature of the changes be that those who are weak in spiritual awareness. Let me read that again. So intense will the nature of the changes be that those, bear with me for a second. Okay, all right. Okay. It's safe. Let me get back to it. I lost my dang place. It said, so intense will the nature of the changes be that those who are weak in spiritual awareness will go insane. So, that's why I'm telling y'all before I start this video, those of y'all who are weak in spirit, do not watch this video. Because some people is going to overwhelm because they have no understanding of the nature of other entities that's about to be coming up on this earth to bring total destruction. You know what I'm saying? It say, so intense will the nature of the changes be that those who are weak in spiritual awareness will go insane. For we are nothing without spirit or the Most High. For we are nothing without spirit, the Most High. All y'all who say ain't nothing we can do about it, you gonna regret them words that you have spoken. You gonna wish and pray that you had seen the Creator of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. They will disappear, for they are just hollow vessels for anything to use. That's why the Bible says vessels of destruction. You know what I'm saying? Nobody in the church won't explain that. The vessels of destruction. You know what I'm saying? Life will be so bad in the cities that many will choose to leave this plane, some in whole groups. So what it's saying is many gonna see the things come on the earth and they literally gonna kill themselves. Let me read that again. They will disappear, for they are just hollow vessels for anything to use. They're talking about those wicked entities that come inside of them. Life will be so bad in the cities that many will choose to leave this plane, some in whole groups. So all y'all who always sit up talking about, hey, y'all telling me this stuff, what we gonna do about it? Ain't nothing we can do about it. Oh, it's plenty you can do about it. You just choose not to because you love this reality. So when it happened, the great event, many gonna kill themselves in thousands of groups because they are weak in spirit and they chose not to prepare their selves. Let's read that we may have understanding. Let the mother speak. All right, let's get with it. Now, you got your own government telling you what we've been saying for years about Nibiru and so-called aliens, but the chariots of Israel, which are spaceships. Even the slaves knew this. Look at the old hymn of the slaves. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. See that? The chosen people, the Negroes, the slaves, the whole world gonna regret for what they have done to the slaves, the Negroes. You know what I'm saying? Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. You know what I'm saying? They gonna regret, like the Apocrypha say, how was he counted amongst the children of God? For we counted his life as nothing. You know what I'm saying? How was he counted amongst the children of God? Because we have always been the chosen children. And we always will be. Regardless how much you manipulate the history, the text, the images, the doctrine, reality, science, it doesn't matter. The chosen will always be the chosen, no matter what the Gentiles do or the wicked ones. The scripture tell you, we have been given victory from the beginning. If you know the beginning, we have victory. Then you know the end, we have victory. Let's read. It says, Pentagon issues official warning over alien mothership UFO sending probes to Earth. Remember when they talk about all the Chinese balloons all over the Earth? They weren't no damn balloons. I've been telling people that. They was probes from Nibiru all over the Earth. I showed some of my friends the video of them orbs flying faster than this damn every jet in the damn military. You know what I'm saying? Those things, they was all over the Earth, probing the Earth. Orbs. And they told y'all they was Chinese balloons. With no damn balloons. They was orbs from the barrel. You know what I'm saying? Go to the right side. Pentagon UFO chief says, alien mothership, which is Nibiru, in our solar system possible. You know, they got to say possible. They got to try to make it sound like it ain't real, but it's real. It's real. If you notice this week just passed, the North Pole and the South Pole, the North Pole turned all red and the South Pole turned all green. That's because the curtain or the veil over the earth is falling. And the archons is about to be pushed out into our reality. You know what I'm saying? Michael is destroying the wicked hierarchy from above. And they ain't got no place to go but down to the third dimension where they will be destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Let's move into the video that you may have overstanding. These articles came up about 3 days ago. I put them up there so you can look them up your damn self. Don't be talking about idea lying. Look it up yourself. You know what I'm saying? Stop being a wuss about stuff. Because whether you're ready or not, this stuff is coming. This year. Let me say that again. This year, they are coming. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. All right, now, the reason why the Divine Mother had me talking about the origin of our God, the origin of our existence, the origin of our DEA is Enki. He is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, period. That's why the Divine Mother got me going to the origin. And like the scriptures say, and the Divine Mother had me say in many videos, if you can't receive this, it's not for you anyway. So there's no need to talk trash. Just move on to a video that is for you. A lower vibrational video. A lower vibrational information. Move on to that and get up out this high vibration information. Because this high vibration stuff, this ain't for low vibration people. This for high vibrational people, you know what I'm saying? Who are evolving to have overstanding and understanding of right truth and right knowledge. Now, this is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who is, they call him, let me break some stuff down about Enki. Now, I'm explaining the picture first. Now you see the dove or the eagle? That's the same eagle that's in Egypt, that's Mayat. Enki is Mayat or Isis in the physical vessel of a man. It's the divine mother, Barbilo, Pistis, Sophia. They took that form in this reality to do creation, which is Metatron. Or Enki, like I said. Now look at the picture. You got the eagle or the dove. You know what I'm saying? Or like Isis, she have the buzzard or the hawk or the eagle. You know what I'm saying? The wings mean wisdom. So that show you that Enki got wisdom. See the eagle? Then you got water. Water mean wisdom. Then you got the fish in the water. Enki is called the fish god. Enki is called the water god. Enki is also called, bear with me for a second. Enki is also called Poseidon. You know what I'm saying? Enki is called, Okay. Enki, through history, Enki is called Ea, Enki. Ptah, Thoth. Okay, I'm gonna give you the kingdom that was ruling when he was called these different things. His first name is Enki or Ea. That's on the Nibiru. In Samaria, he was called Enki. You know what I'm saying? In Egypt, he was called Ptah or Thoth. In Greece, he was called Poseidon. That's why when you watch the movie Percy Jackson, he talk about his daddy is Poseidon. Percy Jackson is us. But they made him an Edomite. Like I said, you can change the images all you want. This truth gonna be brought out. And then in Rome, he was called Neptune. Or he was called Mercury. And in Greece, he was called Poseidon or Hermes, space times trace. And like I said, in Egypt, he was called Ptah or Thoth. You know what I'm saying? And in Samaria, he was called Enki or Nagazidaher. Nagazida. You know what I'm saying? In his number as Enki is number 40. Period. See what I'm saying? Now let's go back to the picture. The picture, they got the dove or the hawk, which represents Maya or the divine mother in wisdom and ascension. You got water, which is wisdom, which is Sophia, Pistis and Sophia. You got the fish, which is the fish god. That's why Christ is called the fish, which the fish is the divine mother. The dove is wisdom, which is the divine mother, Maya. And then on top of his hat, he got five spikes. The five spikes on top of his hat represents the five elements: ether, water, fire, earth, and air. That's why he got the five things on top of his hat. Represents the five elements. He got mastery over them. That's why they on top of his hat. That's why you got 360 days of the year. The last five represents the five elements or the five patriarchs, which is Horus. Osiris, Isis, Horus, Set, and Thoth. You know what I'm saying? The five elements are the five children. You know what I'm saying? Then you got the ram or the goat at his foot, which represents the physical body, the Baphomet, which is Sophia, which is Capricorn. That's why I say Christ was, in some texts say Christ was born in Capricorn. You know what I'm saying? The ram, the horns, the goat. You know what I'm saying? All this stuff go together. And that's why he got his right foot up. His right foot meant royalty and right knowledge and right truth. You know what I'm saying? Look at all that. That is glory. Let's read. It say Enki, Sumerian. Sumerian god of water, knowledge, craft, and creation. It say, and of the Anunnaki. He was later known as Ea, Akkadian, or an Akkadian, Assyrian, Babylonian. The first Babylon was Atlantis. I told y'all that before. The wicked just took the name Babylon to corrupt the original Babylon, which was Atlantis. They, remember, they got to take on the names of everything to corrupt the name. You know what I'm saying? You must understand this. Even this part right here, it's a Babylonia, it's a religion, and is identified by some scholars with, I guess, and I don't know what that say, with something in Canaanite religion. Now see that? They got to put Canaanite because they all trying to talk about we Ham. But how could we possibly be Ham when I told y'all in the video and showed y'all that Enki is the father of Noah? We already know, and Enki is the father of Adam. Enki made the first Adamites. So how could it be the father of Canaanites? Canaanites are Hamites. Noah is of the Shemites. So how could it be the father of the Canaanites when Noah is his daddy? Enki is Noah's daddy. Enki is Gilgamesh's daddy. Enki, Gilgamesh, Noah is Enki's father. I'm all backwards. Noah is the father of Gilgamesh. Enki is the father of Noah. We know all Noah is the father of Shem. So how could he be the god of the Canaanites? That's more corruption, period. You know what I'm saying? So Enki is the god of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, period. All of history, they've been talking about the goat and the ram and the sheep. know what I'm saying? They've been talking about water, which is wisdom. They've been talking about the fish, which is Christ. They've been talking about the elements, which is on the top of the hat of Enki, which is the five elements. They've been talking about wisdom, the dove or the eagle. That's why all the Edomites take the eagle as their symbol. But it's really the symbol of Mayat. You know what I'm saying? All history right there in front of your face, telling you who the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is. Let's read the part at the bottom. The part at the bottom say, bear with me. The part at the bottom say, bear with me. It says, let me get it. Bear with me. The part at the bottom says, it says, in his original form as Enki, he was associated with semen. See that? It's a seed, a lineage, or a pedigree. Not John 3:16, God's love the whole world. It's about a pedigree, a seed, a chosen seed. And amniotic fluid, talking about the semen in a man's seed. That's why when the wicked used to go around killing us, slaughtering us, they used to destroy your sexual organs so you can't produce no seeds. You know what I'm saying? That's why they did that, to stop the man from having children. It say, and therefore with fertility. Fertility is the divine mother. He was commonly represented as half goat, half fish creature. See that? Half goat and half fish. Goat represents Sophia, which is the all five elements. And the fish represents the divine mother, the womb. That's what the fish represents, the womb. See that? The horns represents authority. That's why it can't be the sheep. It has to be the goat. Because the horns, that's what the Bible says, he's going to exalt the horn of Israel. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. All right. Now, what we're going to do is about Enki is this. Enki, Enki represents the sun cycle. Enki also represents the great destroyer. Enki represents the sign of Aquarius. Enki represents the zodiac houses changing to Aquarius. Enki is the water bearer. You see the water that he had around him? Enki is the water bearer. The water bearer is what? Aquarius. That's Enki also. You know what I'm saying? That's why Enki is called Poseidon, because he is the water bearer. You know what I'm saying? And he was given his name by Anu, which is the Most High. I told you, Anu is the Most High, came down in the form of Enki. That's why I said he got different fathers, Enki and Enlil. You know what I'm saying? Enki is also the Lord of Water. He also is, okay, Aquarius, the sign of Aquarius means the last sun cycle too. You know what I'm saying? So you need to understand that. You got four sun cycles. Each sun cycle is a cycle of 9,000 years. Four sun cycles is 36,000 years. We in the last sun cycle now. Every 9,000 years, Nibiru came on the earth. Atlantis, he came. Egypt, he came. Sodom and Gomorrah, it came. And it's coming now, which is the last sun cycle, which is the last 9,000 year cycle, the last sun cycle. Four sun cycles of 9,000 years is 36,000 years. You know what I'm saying? So Enki is Poseidon. Enki is the water bearer. The water bearer is wisdom, ascension. You know what I'm saying? That's why Aquarius is the sign of the new world. Enki. You know what I'm saying? So let's get to the reading of what is going on today. Now, all this information I got, and like I said, it's in the book of the return of the Anunnaki. You know what I'm saying? All this information. Now, this video might be a little long, but that's okay. You know what I'm saying? Because we're going to get this information out. Now, on the left-hand side, this is information about the governments of the earth, especially America, trying to stop what's about to happen on this earth. And we're on the left-hand side. The Return of the Anunnaki, that's the book. You know what I'm saying? Page 132. It say, on the left-hand side, it's in the yellow. It say, how to handle, let me turn the music down. It say, how to handle a close encounter with three different extraterrestrial races that are going to play a prominent role in the future of humanity. See that? Three different terrestrial races. You have the B'nai Or, the Great White Brotherhood, and the wicked ones, the Archons. You know what I'm saying? They telling you the truth because they know this gonna happen. This go back to the video that I played in my other videos when the government say that if it happened in urban communities, you know what I'm saying, where they would have unworldly size and unhuman size and unworldly strength. I did a video about that quite a few times. It say how to handle a close encounter with three different extraterrestrial races that are going to play a prominent role in the future of humanity. It say, bear with me. Petrifying situations. See that? They tell you it's going to be terrible. Petrifying situations. That's why I told y'all, whoever weak in spirit, you don't need to watch this. Because it's going to be terrifying on that great day. Many going to kill themselves or go crazy. You know what I'm saying? Petrifying situations prompted by electric currents and electricity stations and grids shut down during the landing of the extraterrestrial ships on Earth. Let me read that again. Petrifying situations prompted by electric currents and electricity stations and grids shortage. It's talking about electromagnetic fields. I told y'all, I was telling y'all or explaining to y'all when we was having them electrical storms and electric and stuff flashing everywhere, those are chariots inside the clouds that's making all that electric and stuff like that. That's gonna shut down the whole electrical grid on the whole earth when these ships come. It say, prompted by electric currents and electric stations and grids shedding off during the landing of extraterrestrial ships on Earth. See that? Now let me go to, let me hold up for a second. It's saying the development of a global communication system. See that? So when they land, they're going to make a global communication system. Now, we're going to go in the Keys of Enoch. We're going to Keys of Enoch on page 552. On page 552. Let's go to Keys of Enoch on page 552. I'm going to explain what's going to happen this year when these entities come on this earth. They already told us that it's going to happen. You got to go seek out a matter. Like the scriptures say, it is the honor of the Most High to conceal. It's the glory of the Most High to conceal a matter. It is the honor of kings to search it out. We searching out these matters. We on the Keys of Enoch, page 552. I'm going to read verse. I'm going to start at verse 80. Listen at this. Verse 80. It say, three of the most important grid areas are in Tibet, Israel, and Alti America, or South America. So like I was telling y'all for years, or like the Divine Mother was explaining to y'all, Tibet is our people. but they conquered us and made them all light-skinned. Israel is our people, but they conquered us and made them white, or Edomites, Caucasian people. And Alti America is our people, but they made them light-skinned and conquered us, Christopher Columbus. But they really so-called melanated or black people. You know what I'm saying? Three of the most important grid areas around the grid areas, communication, are in Tibet, Israel, and in Alti America. Metatron showed me how the great land of Alti America or South America was to be the new middle land of the earth. It's the meeting place for the scriptures of Tibet being transferred from the east and the scriptures of Israel being transferred from the west. Everything will meet up in South America. And I saw how Alti America became the new grid of unity for creation and the place for the meeting of the higher evolutionary council upon the face of the earth. So that's where someone gonna land at in South America. You know what I'm saying? 83, I was shown by Metatron how America was to be prepared to be the restored area for the returning programmers. See that? The returning programmers, spaceships. It's of the Father's will, Alti America will be seen as a template, meaning a blueprint, or conscious regeneration, global communication. See that? That's why it say right on the left-hand side. It's a petrifying situation, prompted by electric currents and electricity stations and grids shut off during the landing of extraterrestrial ships on Earth. The development of global communication systems. See that? It's saying, I'm gonna go back to 83. See that? It's a communication system of the landing of the extraterrestrials on the Earth. Now I'm gonna go back to the Keys of Enoch, verse 83. Page 552. I was shown the Metatron how America was being prepared to be the restored area for the returning program. See that? Of the Anunnaki. Of the Father or Mother's will, Alti America will be seen as a template or blueprint or consciousness, regeneration, global communication, and the center for the unity among the children of God. So, it's going to be community communication set up in Alti America or in South America. You know what I'm saying? And the Anunnaki going to land there. That's one of the places where they're going to land at. You know what I'm saying? And they're going to set up their communication grid. Let's read. It says, I was also taken over to Talcon Bacon. Wait a minute, bear with me for a second. I was altered with a back of bigger image to Beth Sinai and showed the high frequency pyramids of light. I was shown how the area is used as an entrance threshold to control soul migration, and to soul migration is the ones who go in and out of this realm to go in other realms to be transformed into children of light. And from the planet, see that? To and from the planet. And is used by the hierarchy of the Father and Mother for the incarnation of masters into the earth plane. See that? We go in and out of these grids or these portals so that we can transform and come back into the earth and go out of the earth, or in this dimension or to another dimension, to the third dimension, to the fourth dimension, to the fifth dimension. That's what the Anunnaki gonna do when they get here. They're gonna set up communication grids. You know what I'm saying? And you got our Americas talking about that. It's a petrifying situation prompted by electric currents and I'm back on the screen, at electric stations and grid shut off during the landing of the extraterrestrial ships on Earth, the development of a global communication system jointly administrated by the Anunnaki. Let me read that again. The development of a global communication system jointly administrated by the Anunnaki. See that? The Anunnaki, Nibiru, they're not going to come off Nibiru and they're going to land on Earth and they're going to set up communication grids all over the Earth. Now we're going to find out why they're going to set them. Now we're going to find out why the Anunnaki are setting up these grids. It says the United States of America, China, Russia, and Europe for the purpose of informing the population of Earth of the landing, the purpose of the landing, and areas of landing of the Anunnaki and their Merkabas. See that? Let me read that again. Listen carefully. You know what I'm saying? It's saying, bear with me. Let me read this again. Listen this carefully. It say, the development of a global communication system jointly administrated by the Anunnaki. The United States will be one of the grids. China will be one of the grids. That's why I told you. The Chinese, they are people too. When we left Atlantis, we went to China too. We went to China first, actually. Russia will be one of our places where they set up these grids. In Europe, Scotland, Ireland, and Britain. For the purpose of informing the population of Earth of the landing, the purpose of the landing, and areas of landing. So they're going to tell you why they landed, what they landing for, and where they landing at. You know what I'm saying? Of the Anunnaki and their Merkabas in several areas of the terrestrial globe or Earth. Now let's go to keys. So it's telling you why they landing, where they going to land, and what the purpose of their landing is for. Let's go to keys, page 332, to find this out. Let's go to page 332. Let's read and find out why they landing and what they're going to tell you about that. Page 332 in the Keys of Enoch, verse 19. We're going to start at verse 19. Okay. It says, Merkaba speaks of Merkaba goals. Follow, O children, the road of Zion. Look at that. Follow, O children, the road of Zion. What is the road of Zion? What is the road of Zion? The road of Zion is Israel. Period. That is the road of Zion. Israel. It's a chosen seed. Period. It's a, and let Jerusalem be inhabited in peace and in holiness from this time forth unto all times forever. So when we get restored, we ain't gonna never fall again. 20. The seraphim tell us, rejoice, children of uprightness and light. The crystalline fields of light upon your doorposts of the body temple. It's talking about your pineal gland. The doorposts inside your pineal gland, the crystals inside your pineal gland, you know what I'm saying, have been activated, for you are part of the greater star seed. See that? The Anunnaki, the star seeds, the star travelers. Bear with me. You are part of the star seed of the Anunnaki. That's just the bottom line. You know what I'm saying? And what they're doing is they're coming back to get their chosen children. You know what I'm saying? That's just the bottom line. They're coming back to get their chosen children. And we need to know that. You know what I'm saying? So, let's continue to read. It's saying, The seraphim tell us, rejoice, children of uprightness and light, the crystalline field of light upon your doorposts. That's in your brain. Of the body temple have been activated. That's your pineal gland. For you are part of the great star seed. See that? That's why Christ said, I am from above and ye are from below. Christ is our big brother. So we are from above as well. 21. And the name of the temple within you, see, your pineal gland, which shall not receive the angel of death. See, you become immortal. But the angel of light is called Amen. Amen is the divine mother. Amen Ra. Amen is the mother. Ra is the father. The Amen is identified with the people of God. Rather, they are on On Memphis, Bathsheba, Bethlehem, Megiddo, and I was telling y'all about Megiddo anyway. That didn't I tell y'all in my last video? I was explaining to y'all that Megiddo is where they gonna land at. That's why you got all the armies of the earth around Bathsheba, Bethlehem, On Memphis. This in Egypt. On Memphis is in Egypt. This where they're going to land at. It say the Amen is identified with the people of God. Rather, they are on Amen Memphis, which is in Egypt. Bathsheba, which is in the Middle East. Bethlehem in the Middle East. Megiddo in the Middle East. Or the basin of the Great Salt Lakes and in South America. See, that's where they're going to all be landing at. You know what I'm saying? Now, let's go back. Let me finish this. That's where they're all going to be landing at. All of these faithful communities will rejoice because there the light has already been centered in the crystalline fields beneath these cities. So underground, you got grids that's going to come up and they're going to activate and give communication. And this is what they're going to do for the people. 22. So prepare, children of Zion, to the children of Israel. Your communities is to be organized as a defensive family against attack. See, that's why I told y'all, let me read that again. It says, so prepare, children of Zion. Your communities is to be organized as a defensive family against attack. See that? That's why Megiddo, Like I was explaining on my last video, why all the armies around the world is stationing themselves all over there. They station themselves in Memphis, Bathsheba, Bethlehem, Megiddo, and Great Salt Lakes. You know what I'm saying? They position the militaries around all these places. So when the ships land, they can attack them. But that's where the Most High say, he gonna bring them all over there to destroy them. See, they think they're gonna attack us, but they not. Now they downplaying this right here. Look how low level they saying it. So prepare, children of Zion. Your communities is to be organized as a defensive family against attack. See, that's low level. Instead of them saying, y'all about to get spiritual powers. Let's read 23. It say, be protected at the first sign of danger, as the communities of Quran, that is, if attacked from the nations of the earth, see that? All the nations, didn't it say all the nations gonna attack the children of Israel? We gonna be over there in our cities when they get transformed, and they gonna come try to, that's why right now, all the armies around the earth, they're over there talking about what they're going to do to each other. They ain't going to do nothing. They're preparing for the spaceships to land upon the earth. That's what they're preparing for. They're preparing to attack us, but it ain't going to work. Listen to this. Page 332, verse 23. It say, be prepared at the first sign of danger, as the communities of Quran, that is, if attacked from the nations of the earth, come close. 1/5 should be mobilized. That means 1/5 of our mighty army. Joel 2, the mighty army of the Most High. You know what I'm saying? It say, if the nations of the earth come close, because they're going to know we're there. They already know where we're going to land at. They're going to land at. 1/5 should be mobilized. See that? That's the mighty army. Then the 2/5, the 3/5, then the 4/5, and finally the entire force of the community should be mobilized. See that? The mighty army. We're going to have spiritual powers. You know what I'm saying? That's why they gathered all in the Middle East, because that's one of the main landing places of the ships of the Most High. You know what I'm saying? And they know it. Megiddo is one of the main places. You know what I'm saying? And that's where we're going to whoop their behinds at. They're going to be judged there. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. It say, the communities is a nucleus of light. See that? A nucleus. We're going to be shining like the sun over that month. The angels of war. And the communities of light, which are under the holding pattern of the sons of light, will be protected by the Merkaba vehicles against the sons of darkness. See that? Now let's go back on the screen and read it again, what it say. So the Merkaba ship's going to come down. Listen what it say. I'm back on the screen. Look at number 12. It say, the development of global communications systems jointly administrated by the Anunnaki, or the Great White Brotherhood, the United States of America, China, Russia, and Europe, for the purpose of informing the population of Earth of the landing, of the purpose of the landing, and the area of the landing of the Anunnaki and their Merkabas. See that? The Merkaba ships in several areas of the terrestrial globe. And I told you the several areas. The Keys of Enoch explain a lot of this. One is on Memphis, that's one. Beersheba, two. Bethlehem, three. Megiddo, four. Or the basin of the Great Salt Lake, five. All are these faithful communications. So you got also China, which is six. And you also got, let's say, China and Russia, which is seven. You know what I'm saying? All these places are the places where they go land at, all over the earth. That's why I say Israel is scattered to the four corners of the earth. All these lands took over our people and conquered them. Genghis Khan in China, you know what I'm saying? All over there. Because when Genghis Khan conquered us in China, he did it in Russia. He did it in Europe. You know what I'm saying? In the Middle East, I forgot the guy's name. With the Ottoman Empire, they conquered us. And you know in America, it was the Christopher Columbus and them. You know what I'm saying? Who conquered us over time. And also the Greeks. With Alexander the Greek. They conquered us. You know what I'm saying? So those are the history stories of them conquering us. That's what all those wars is all about. Conquering us. You know what I'm saying? So now it say, let's go back to the screen. It say, in several areas of the terrestrial globe, talking about the earth, it say, these community systems will also be projected as a huge hologram screen that will appear in the sky at the close proximity of the surface of the earth, containing vital information intended to orient the people of the earth. Okay, now, that right there, let me see. That right there is right there in verse 22 and 23 on page 332 in the Keys of Enoch. It tell you that they're going to let us know what's going on. Look, in 22, it says, so prepare the children of Zion, your communities, to be organized as a defensive family against attack. See that? So they going to land to warn us what's going on. We going to get the information. 23. Be protected at the first sign of danger. See that? So they're going to warn us. Let me see. I'm going to go to Keys of Enoch. Okay, let me read this again. It say, this communication system will also be projected as a huge hologram screen. So in the sky, see, that's where the Edomites get that from. The Blue Beam Project, how they going to project fake alien ships and stuff like that. This is what the Anunnaki going to do. See, it say, this communication system will also be projected as a huge holographic screen that will appear in the sky at the close proximity of the surface of the earth, containing vital information intended to orient the people of the earth. So it's going to tell us what to do, where to go, what's going on, and all that. You know what I'm saying? So let's go to page 556. Let's go to page 556 of the Keys of Enoch. Page 556. Let's go to page 556. 556. Now we're going to go to verse 130. Verse 130. Okay. Verse 130. Now I say it's going to project a hologram image, and it's going to tell the people on earth what's going on. It say the communication system will also be projected as a huge holographic screen that will appear in the sky at the close proximity of the surface of the earth, containing vital information intended to orient the people of the earth. Now, I'm in the Keys of Enoch on page 556, verse 130. It said, the landing of the temples of the heavenly city of Jerusalem will be preceded by a landing of the Bnei Or. So that's what they talk about. The Bnei Or gonna land on the earth before the Jerusalem command come down. And it said the Bnei Or, who will bear testimony to the only begotten Son and to the abomination of desolation, the false priesthood that enslaved the souls in the concept of the simplicity of heaven, earth, and the underworld, where no real soul growth can take place. So what they said is they lied to us about the underworld, which is Agarthia, the divine place of the angels, the secret place of the angels. They lied to us about the earth, what it really was, what these temples were, who lived in these temples, and heaven, what's coming from heaven, and what heaven really is. See, it's a the simplicity of heaven. Heaven is Nibiru. They made it sound all simple, like it's no big deal. So they lied to us. Heaven is Nibiru. The earth got grids where all the so-called black people lived at. And the underworld is a Agartha. They lied about all of that, where we couldn't grow. That's why I say, where no real soul growth can take place. See? They lied to us about everything. They're going to reveal the truth to us, though, and tell us everything. That's why I said these community systems will also be projected as a huge holographic screen that will appear in the sky at the close proximity of the surface of the earth, containing vital information intended to orient the people of the earth. Now go to 14. It say, you will have no remembrance what we have said in the past about the remaining portion of the people of the earth. Now I'm going to read from, bear with me, 120, I'm going to read from, well, I'm going to wait on that. It say, for you have to remember what we have said in the past. So what I've ever said, remember your history about the remaining portion of the people of the earth, those who were saved, see that? Took in those portals and stuff like that. And when you go into Agartha, you go into a portal too, another dimension. Those who will perish and those who will not be allowed to ascend through the Babs or the Stargates. The ascension through the Stargates is their only way of salvation, because the earth gonna be so messed up, you're going to have to go into another dimension to be saved, or places of protection to make it sound low grade, how they say it, you're going to need to go and place some protection, period. Now, let's go to page. We're going to go to another page in Return of the Anunnaki. And we're going to read about, go to the left-hand side. Left-hand side of the page. It say, now I told y'all this before in the last video. It say, this ain't on the pavement, read it anyway. It said, first, one must remember that in an instant, the houses these people live in, any animal that they have had, all the plants of the earth, and many other buildings will disappear in a blink of an eye. Like the Bible said, in a blink of an eye, they shall be taken. Okay, now we're on the screen. It say, some may remember the warning of the Anunnaki, or the Most High, or the Holy Spirit. The warning the Holy Spirit gave us. Okay, now this warning is say started 14 years ago before the event. So 14 years before the event. Let me break that down. Remember in the story of Joseph when he had the dream of seven fat cows and seven skinny cows, seven fat ears of corn and seven skinny ears of corn? That's 14 years. Seven and seven. 14 years. That meant that this event was going to happen twice. The seven fat cows and seven skinny cows. That means prepare, and when the famine comes, you will survive. And it also means now. The 7 years are going to happen twice. The last 14 years. Now, it said, some may remember the warnings of the Anunnaki. I'm going to say the Divine Mother. Started 14 years ago. So what that's saying is, remember when all the Israelites on the corners warning all the people and they ridiculed us, laughed at us, said we was crazy? Those black Hebrew Israelites are a terrorist group. They crazy. They are caught. See, that was the warning that nobody wanted to listen to. That's why I say so many remember the warnings of the mother, or the Anunnaki, started 14 years ago. We woke up 14 years ago in 2011. You know what I'm saying? Before the event, after the 14 years, the event gonna happen. The same thing like Joseph said, the seven and seven. 7 years of fat cows, 7 years of skinny cows. 7 years of fat corn, 7 years of skinny corn. You know what I'm saying? It said before the great event and constantly repeated but ignored. See that? We repeated over and over and over again what was going to take place. And the whole world ignored those black Hebrew Israelites on the corners telling the truth what's going to happen. It say before the event and constantly repeated but ignored by many. See that? Others may have never seen, never even noticed the warnings. Exactly. Because when they saw them black men on the corner, the so-called black men on the corner, they paid us no mind. And so they have no clue as to what is happening. It say none of that matters, since one must also remember that these people are evil to the core, that nothing can reclaim them because they have nothing which is good in their minds and in their mind. Let me stop right there. So what it's saying, the Bible say, I think in Genesis, when it say the wicked ones have constantly wickedness in their hearts, I mean, they think of evil 24/7. How to destroy us. That's all in their mind, how to destroy us. But it ain't gonna work. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna read that to you. It say, and the Anunnaki have absolutely no mercy and no sympathy about evil and its redemption. It say, the Anunnaki firmly believe that all evil should be destroyed. You know what I'm saying? It say, at this point, the Son. Now, this is the part that's going to shock people if you're not ready for this. At this point, the sun and the moon, depending on the time zone, would seem to be eclipsed. This will not happen naturally, but rather the whole sky over the entire world will be covered with spaceships. Let me read that again. It's a, at this point, the sun and the moon, depending on the time zone. So that's why it's saying when the beer will come, it's going to make the sun and the moon and the stars move out their place. And it's going to be total darkness on the earth. You know what I'm saying? Let's read. It says, at this point, the sun and the moon, depending on the time zone, would seem to be eclipsed. This will not happen naturally, but rather the whole sky over the entire world will be covered with spaceships. The whole world will be covered with spaceships. The whole world will be covered with spaceships and motherships. See that? Spaceships and motherships. A massive ceiling of metal, shapes of machinery, gadgets, wheels within wheels, and shifting lights will be created. They will be ominously silent, as if waiting, looking at this form from below will be so frightening that many people will lose their heads. No, many people will kill themselves. Just like the Hopi said, many will choose to kill themselves or leave this realm. You know what I'm saying? So, let's go to Keys, page 556. Let's go to Keys Enoch, page 556. Now, let's read from verse 124 to 132. Why the skies gonna go black? I'm going to start at page 124. Listen to this. It say, I saw fiery wheels. That's the same thing it say on the Anunnaki. It say, the metal shapes of machinery, gadgets, wheels within wheels. See that? Now I'm in the Keys of Enoch, page 556, verse 124. Y'all can read this on your own. It say, next, I saw fiery wheels which covered the sky. See that? I saw fiery wheels which covered the sky. See that? The Anunnaki ships gonna cover the whole heavens. It's gonna black out the sun and the moon and the stars. It's gonna be that many ships. That's why the Bible say when Christ come, he gonna come with 10,000 upon 10,000 upon 10,000 of his saints to execute judgment upon the earth. See how all this coming together now? It say, I saw fiery wheels which covered the sky, and these wheels came to rest upon the earth. See that? Spaceships. They became temples of light as they opened to receive the righteous rescue from the convulsions of the earth. See that? They go land on the earth and pick up the righteous. And they're going to take them to places of protection, to the fourth and fifth dimensions. You know what I'm saying? And other in the Agarthia. You know what I'm saying? All over the place in other realms. And they're going to go through portals. You know what I'm saying? And they're going to land upon the earth like I'm trying to tell you. You know what I'm saying? 10,000 upon 10,000 upon 10,000 of its angels. It say, they became temples of light as they opened to receive the righteous rescue from the convulsions of the earth, to my the massive earthquakes. Others were taken beneath the ocean. See that? That's why I said the ones who lied about Agarthia, who lied about the earth, and who lied about the heavens. Others were taken beneath the oceans into gravity null zones, islands of light. See, that's when you're going to disappear into places of protection. You know what I'm saying? Into the fourth and fifth dimension. When you go into a garden under the earth, you go into the fourth and fifth dimension. That's what that bubble was talking about. They're going to go inside the bubble. The bubble is the fourth and fifth dimension, or a garden. You know what I'm saying? I was telling you all that. I explained that in the last video. It say, which were pyramids in the skies of underwater mountains. In these islands' atmospheres, the remnant of the good seed and the earth were prepared for the cycle of the reign of Christ. See that? When you go to the fourth, fifth dimension, you're going to be prepared for the reign of Christ. You know what I'm saying? But you're going to be able to see everything in the third dimension. Upon the earth. See that? In union with the higher worlds of light. Let's keep reading. Bear with me for a second. Let me see where I stop at. 32. Okay. It say, and I saw how the brotherhoods of light watch this and other planets and go through cycles of experimentation for billions of years. So this happened many times before other planets, and how each planet goes through a great purification. And that's what Earth about to go through, the purification of the Anunnaki, the destroyer. You know what I'm saying? The destroyer of the Gentile, like the Bible said, is on its way, which is the bearer of great purifications before the great leap forward. I saw how many of the watchmen observe God's creation operate from energy platforms woven into the grid structure. See, woven. The fourth and dimension, the fourth and fifth dimension overlap each other. And the fourth dimension overlap the third dimension. That's how you're going to be able to see from the fourth into the third. So they watch the whole time what everybody is doing. The watchers. The good watchers, not the bad ones. Woven into the grid structures of gravitational matrix. 127. And it was revealed to me what the great vicissitudes or earthquakes would also open up underground areas to the fourth dimension of the earth that were used by the Brotherhood of Lights in previous eons of time. Exactly. And I understood the meaning of the artificial lakes of sand at Memphis and Midianot Hebel. So that's talking about this desert in the Middle East. I saw that they were placed there as symbolic preparations for the landing of the heavenly vehicles. See that? Spaceships. The landing of the heavenly vehicles. You know what I'm saying? The so-called temple ships. These lakes were built specifically to illustrate how the temple ships of the Lord of Light come to receive the living and the dead. So even some of the ones who are asleep, it's going to take them. You know what I'm saying? The living and the dead. That's talking about the living that's already in Agarthia and the dead and the ones on the earth who qualify for navigation into the heavens. It say, I saw the vehicles of Kishon. That's why it said many different types of species going to be on the earth. I saw the vehicles of Kishon as a temple of light circling the cities of Megiddo. That's why I read in Megiddo, we gonna be in places of protection and the ships gonna circle around that, but we gonna do battle from there because they're gonna try to attack us in Megiddo. Now this saying the same thing in Megiddo. Megiddo, Aleppo, Jerusalem, and Harbor. Those are all places in the Middle East. Directing the vehicle temples of light to key areas of the earth. See that? Where they interconnect with the coming communities of light. 130. The landing of the temples of the heavenly city of Jerusalem will be preceded by the landing of the B'nai Or, who will bear testimony to the only begotten Son and to the abomination of desolation, false priesthood of the enslaved men, the souls of the in the concept of a simplistic heaven, earth, and underworld, there where no real soul can grow, growth can take place. And say the B'nai Or will bring the new law and educate man to build temple communities of light. And Metatron said, a new meridian of time will come and the foundation of the earth will be shifted to a new magnetic field. It's a foundation as the orbs of the earth is reset within the oceans of light. Bear with me. It said, those who seek spiritual redemption and autonomy from the structures of the powers will build communities of love and light through the world. They will use the souls and muscles of fashioning healing centers of light and teaching centers where the love of God prepares the young to use the spiritual gifts and creativity. So basically what they said is you're going to be transformed in the spirit, spiritual entities. You know what I'm saying? Now that's another part I wanted to read. Bear with me. Bear with me. Let me see. Okay. Now one more part. One more part. It say. Bear with me. Let's see, 124, 123, 132, 115. Okay. I'm gonna read something. Well, that's all I'm gonna do. Because these ships that's gonna land on the earth is gonna be many. You know what I'm saying? And they gonna land the Merkabas that's gonna come. A lot of people gonna be scared when they see all these Merkabas. They're going to be tripping because they're going to never believe it. They're not going to believe that alien ships going to come down on the earth. And it's going to be so many, they're going to black out the heavens. You know what I'm saying? You ain't going to be able to see the sun or the moon, nor the stars. You know what I'm saying? All these things going to happen in a blink of an eye. You know what I'm saying? And there was one more thing that I wanted to bring out, and now I can't find it. Let me see. Let me see. Merkaba ships. Okay, this is what I was going to read. Okay, now I'm going to read why all these ships going to come down on the earth. The wicked, they're going to come down because Michael cleaning out the heavens. You know what I'm saying? Now let me read that real fast. Did I read that? Let me see. Michael, let me see if I read that by Michael cleansing out the heavens. Bear with me for a second. Michael cleansing out the heavens. Let me see if I read that. I think I did. Bear with me. Let me see. Page 332. Let me see. Okay, let me, okay, page 332, verse 15. Page 332, verse 15. Let me see, let me make sure I read that. Page 332. verse 15. It say, okay, this Michael who gonna cleanse out the heaven. It say, let the scroll be read and cherished by the hearts of humanity and by the scrolls of souls of pity. It say, for we are on the verge of a great great ordeal and woe to the unjust who follow after iniquity. It say, the unheavals that are moving upon the earth are the consequence of a great cleansing. See that? Michael cleansing the heavens above. That is taking place throughout the heavens. See that? The order of Michael is purifying all realms of the intelligent beings at the highest level. See that? Michael cleansing out the highest levels in all the archons gonna come down to the lowest levels. And say, the order of Michael is purifying all realms of intelligence, beginning at the highest level of creation and including many of the space brotherhoods who have used a technology of death. And as a result, they are being removed from the centers of the galaxy and set back several evolutionary dimensions. And say, this is why there are grotesque intelligence now occupying the atmosphere of the planets like our own, for they have been recycled to the edge of space so as to be humbled in the painful path of evolutionary. And right, it is a painful path of evolutionary renewal. But these grotesque forms only constitute a portion of the mutation created by the fallen masters of light. Now check this out, 16. Many of these grotesque forms, along with their masters of light, who are of the atomic appearance, are being placed in the regions that will be vacated by the planet like Earth as the Earth is advanced to a higher orbit frequency. So what that's saying is, when we come off the Earth and the Earth is cleansed, the grotesque beings or the archons, they gonna come back on the Earth when the Earth renewed, and they gotta go through what we went through. Go into the bodies and go through an evolutionary process to be renewed like we did, and come out the bodies and be cleansed and restored to become good entities, not bad entities. That's the same thing happened to us when we sinned. We had to come into the body, be cleansed, and go back up and be renewed to be divine entities. That's gonna happen to the archons. They're gonna go through the same thing we went through. Like the Archeist Enoch said, go through the 7,000 year cycle again. You know what I'm saying? Now, let me read about the Merkabas. It say, I'm on page 344 in the Keys of Enoch, verse 34. It say, Merkaba is the radiation of light which ties through form creation of the Father and Mother universe, the Sun universe, and the Sun universe to the lower universe of living technology, still evolving in the realms of the seven mansion world, to this lower world. The light will be of the lower luminaries. Merkaba is the witness of the beings of the prophets or the prophetic consciousness forms of levels to other levels of creation. And without Merkaba, no man can enter into the presence of the Father. The Merkaba is the emanation of light returning to the bosom of the Mother and Father. It say the bit of Elijah going into Merkaba, of Isaiah seeing the Merkaba, and Ezekiel experiencing Merkaba, all speaks of Merkaba as a form of time translation for the prophets of the light. They receive their orders, their great commission from the higher life systems of teaching planetary intelligence on behalf of the hierarchies of light. See what I'm saying? So the Merkaba is what Isaiah, Elijah, in let me see, what it say? Let me get the page again. Dang. Bear with me for a second. Bear with me. Oh, Merkaba. Okay, bear with me for a second. Let me get Merkaba again. Okay. It say Elijah. When Elijah took it up, he was taken up by Merkaba. Those are the wheels of fire. Isaiah was took up by wheels of Merkaba. And Ezekiel was taken up by wheels of Merkaba. So all the chariots of Israel, they call them in the Bible chariots of Israel or horses of fires. But they Merkabas. And they're going to come back and take us up. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to be able to move through different dimensions with these Merkabas. And these Merkabas, which are the stars up in the heavens, gonna come down, which is your Christ over self, gonna come down on you, and they gonna turn you into divine men, like I was telling y'all before. So these things gonna happen. People need to be ready for these great events that's gonna take place on earth. So with that being said, I thank y'all for coming out. I thank y'all for listening to the video. These things gonna happen this year. All kind of shit's gonna come down on the earth, and they're gonna fill the skies up, and a lot of people gonna see them, and they're gonna lose their mind because they're not gonna be ready, or they have not prepared themselves spiritually. Like the Hopi Indian said, you need to prepare yourself spiritually for these things that's gonna come on the earth, and a lot of people not prepared for this. That's why the Bible said most people is not gonna be prepared for the things that's gonna come on the earth, and they not. You know what I'm saying? But that's what the Divine Mother had me doing today. Preparing y'all for what's going to come on this earth. These aliens, these species, these things, and the archons. But everything has been staged over there in Megiddo. You know what I'm saying? That's one of the main landing places. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, peace and love to the gods known and unknown. You know what I'm saying? Also, I give thanks to the angel of ether. I give thanks to the angel of water. I give thanks to the angel of fire. I give thanks to the angel of earth. And I give thanks to the angel of air. Peace and love to the gods known and unknown. To all four corners on the earth. I thank the Divine Mother for giving me wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You know what I'm saying? I am all that is natural. And all that is natural is me. You know what I'm saying? Peace and love, brothers and sisters. Shalom. Don't talk about my father. 'Cause God is my friend. He loves us whether.